Sairam students, how are you all? I hope that you all are very fine and healthy in your home with all your family members. And I also hope that you all are be in touch with your learning. So for the same, we are your teachers come to help you with the help of digital platform. So I hope that we will be good together. Good morning, class. I am Damini Mehta, your maths teacher for this academic year for your standard 7th. First of all, we start our today's class with the introduction of our maths textbook. So you are seeing the front page of your maths textbook. Then we go through the index page. There are total 15 chapters we have for this year in maths. So we will start our today's class for our very first chapter, integers. So class, this is the first page of our chapter. As we have learnt about whole numbers and integers in our previous class also. So what integers are? Integers are the collection of whole numbers and negative numbers. That means we can say that integers is a group in which positive numbers are present, negative numbers are present, and zero is also included in integers. So before further, we have to recall that what integers exactly are. So we will have a quick look on that.
We have seen what natural and whole numbers are. The whole numbers comprise of the entire set of natural numbers and zero. So what are integers then? Let's zoom in a bit. Along with whole numbers, the set of integers also includes negative numbers like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. We have numbers like 1, 2, 3, and so on, so that we can count. We also know why we have a zero. Now the question, why negative numbers? The most basic example would be temperature. The temperature can go below 0 degrees, and the temperature below 0 degree is negative, like minus 10 degrees. Let us see a different example. Suppose you gave your friend 100 rupees and that friend returned just 50 rupees. What is the net amount you have now? The net amount you have is minus 50 rupees. We know there is no note available in the market which amounts to minus 50 rupees. But a negative sign tells us that you are in a loss. Coming back to integers, all these numbers are integers. We zoom out slightly to understand another interesting concept. The numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on are called positive integers, and numbers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on are called negative integers. We can also define natural numbers as positive integers. Then what about zero? Well, it's neither positive nor negative. Now look at all three of them together. It tells us that all natural numbers and whole numbers are integers. The set of integers would look something like this. And the set of integers are represented by the letter Z. Now we know what integers are and why they are used.
Now class, you know that integers too possess some properties and operations in between them. So, in next video, we will learn about addition and subtraction operation in between integers. Okay, class, we have learned that similar sign will add and different sign will subtract each other. So on the basis of these, we will solve our first exercise. So the first question of this exercise is, they're given the temperature of various places on a particular day. So the first part of this question is, we have to observe the given number line and we have to write the temperature of these various places on the basis of that number line. So see, the temperature of Bengaluru is 22 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Ooty is 14 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Shimla is 5 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Srinagar is minus 2 degrees Celsius. And the temperature of Lahore Spiti is minus 8 degrees Celsius. Okay, I hope that this is very clear to all of you. Now the next part is, what is the temperature difference between the hottest and the coolest? Now see, this is the hottest one and this is the coolest one. So the difference between hottest and coolest, the temperature of hottest place is 22 degree. So we have to find the difference. So we have to subtract the coolest one, which is minus 8. Minus 8. So 22 and similar sign will add. So 22 plus 8 will be 30. So the answer of B part is 30. I hope it is very clear to all of you. Now the C part is, what is the temperature difference in Lahore Spiti and Srinagar? So the temperature of Lahore Spiti is minus 8 and the temperature of Srinagar is minus 2. So we have to separate the smaller one from the greater one. So minus 2, minus minus 8. So you know that similar sign will become addition. So now minus 2 plus 8. Now two different signs we have. So different sign will subtract, means we have to subtract both of them. So we get 6 answer and we get the sign of the bigger number. So the answer is positive 6. Okay, now next part is, can we say that the temperature of Srinagar and Shimla taken together is less than the temperature of Shimla? Means taken together means we have to add the temperature of Srinagar and Shimla. So the temperature of Srinagar is minus 2 and the temperature of Shimla is 5. So we have to add both of them. So positive 5 minus 2. We have to add them, or I will make it more clear as 5 plus minus 2. That means two different sign will subtract. So we have to subtract both of them. So we will get answer 3 and the sign of bigger one, which is plus 3. So the answer is plus 3. Now we have to compare that this resultant temperature is less than the temperature of Shimla or not. So the temperature of Shimla is plus 5 and the resultant is plus 3. So the statement is correct. Means we can say that the temperature of Shimla is less than the temperature taken together of Srinagar and Shimla. Now the second part of the question is it also less than the temperature of Srinagar? They are saying that, or asking that, the resultant temperature, which is positive 3, is also less than the temperature of Srinagar, which is minus 2. So the answer is no, because minus 2 is smaller than plus 3. Okay, so now we will go to our next question. The next question, second question is, in a quiz, see, in a quiz competition, positive marks are given for every correct answer and negative marks are given for incorrect answer. So on the basis of this, a boy, Jack, who's scored for 5 successful rounds, means for the first round, his score is 25, for the second round, his score is minus 5, for the third round, his score is minus 10, and for fourth, 15, and for fifth, it is 10. So we have to find the total marks or total score scored by Jack at the end of the quiz. So we will solve this question. See class, this is the solution of first question, means the second one, Jack question. These are the marks scored by Jack on all 5 successful rounds. Now we have to add them. So see, this is the way we have to write, okay? So the first two signs are positive and negative together, then they will be subtract. Similarly here, two different sign will subtract. Now we have other positive and single sign, so we have to write them as same. Now see, first we have to write all the positive number together and negative number together, then add all the positive number, we get 50, and add all the negative number, we get 15. Now again there are two signs, positive 50 and negative 15, so two different sign will subtract, so we get 35 and we have the sign of bigger number. Class, the next question is question number 3. At Srinagar, temperature was minus 5 degrees Celsius on Monday and it dropped by 2 degrees Celsius on Tuesday, means it decreases 2 degrees more from 5 degrees Celsius. Okay, means if temperature on Monday is 5 degrees Celsius, so the temperature on Tuesday will be minus 5 minus 2. Okay, we have to subtract 2 from minus 5. So the further question is, what was the temperature of Srinagar on Tuesday? So we have to find the temperature of Srinagar on Tuesday. Okay class, so this is the solution of that question. The temperature of Srinagar on Monday is minus 5 and it dropped down by 2 degrees Celsius on Tuesday. So we have to subtract 2 from minus 5. So the equation is minus 5 minus 2. Okay, so similar sign, so it will add. So we add 5 and 2, we get 7, and we have to put the sign of minus in resultant integer. So the further question is, they are asking for that if the temperature will rose by 4 degrees Celsius on Wednesday, then what will be the temperature on Wednesday? So see, the temperature rose by 4 degrees Celsius in as compared to Tuesday. So we have to solve the question for Wednesday on the basis of day Tuesday. Okay, this is your homework, you have to solve it. Okay class, now class we will go for sixth question. The question is, Rita goes 20 km towards east from a point A to B. That means from a point A she goes towards east 20 km towards east and reach a point B. Then from B she moves 30 km towards west along the same road. So along the same road she moves towards west and reaches a final point F. Then the question is, if the distance towards east is represented by positive integer, so we have to answer that how we will represent the distance traveled toward west. See, west is exactly opposite side or exactly opposite direction of east. So if east is represented as positive, so west will be represented in negative. Okay, so the answer of this question, how will you represent the direction toward west, is negative. Now, further question is, by which integer will you represent her final position from A? That means we have to give the distance between the initial to final position. See, that means we have to solve 20 kilometer and 30 kilometer. Now, 20 kilometer will be taken as positive and 30 kilometer will be taken as negative. So we will get two different signs. So these both integers will subtract and we will get 10, and sign will be of greater number. Class, this is the proper solution of question 6. You can easily see from this clip. Now question number 7, in which we have to find out that which of the given square is a magic square. Now see, what is a magic square? Magic square is that square in which the sum of all the column and all the row and the sum of diagonal will be same. So you have to check that after adding that which of the square is a magic square. After that, we will go to question number 8, in which we have to verify given equation for given value of A and B. Yes class, this is the solution for question number 8. Second part, we have to verify this equation for the given value of A and B. How we have to solve it? We have to put the given value of A and B in that equation. So this is the equation we have, and we put the value of A in place of A and value of B in place of B. So we get that equation, 118 minus, and then in bracket, minus 125 equals to 118 plus 125. Now we have to solve it, and we get that on both the side of equals, we get the same number. So the given equation is verified. Now class, in question number 9, we have to put greater, smaller and equal sign in boxes for the given statement. Yes class, this is the first part of question number 9. This is, and we have to solve this side and this side, then we will get to know that which sign is appropriate for given statement. So we have to solve according to the rules of addition and subtraction for integers. Two different sign will subtract, same sign will add, and then similarly same sign will add and two different sign will subtract. Then the given statement, according to given statement, minus 12 is smaller than minus 4. As you all know that in negative integers, greater number will be smaller than smaller number because of the negative sign. Now we will solve one more part of question number 9, part D, which is this. Two different sign will subtract, two different sign will subtract, same sign will add. Okay, now we have to add both negative sign first and we have to add both positive number first. Then we will get this statement according to which this part is smaller than this one. Now class, this is the home assignment for you for exercise 1.1. The other question which we did as classwork in this video, you also have to do all those questions in your notebook, and this is your self-practice questions.